I'm really sad that my coffee doesn't taste very good today, by the way.
Coffee, not for me. Not for me. I feel very hungover today, but I don't drink and I never have drank in my life. I'm literally wearing sunglasses. Did you have that crazy ass thunderstorm last night?
Oh my God, all fucking day yesterday.
I was like, bitch, I can't fucking sleep. Josh woke up and asked me what the fuck that was. And I was like, Thor, who else? Bitch, like
Bit.
what?
Like obviously, like
Who
who did
else
you
would it be? Thor is having a fucking concert in the sky. He's fighting someone. We gotta let it go.
let it go? He's saving the universe right now.
Yeah, it's probably him and Elsa up there, like jamming. Let it go. Thor, Love and Thunder. Like, period. All right, do the intro, Jessica. We're talking here, and we didn't even do the
Oh my
intro.
God, I know. You are now listening to Random Things starring Random Bitches. I did it.
What up, everybody? Thank you for tuning in.
Tuning in. Thanks for listening.
Yeah, we so appreciate you here. I want to give a quick shout out to Reese Witherspoon. Today is the 20th anniversary of my fucking favorite movie of all time, Legally Blonde.
Is that really your favorite movie of all time?
Yeah, premium content. Like, I love that movie. Of all time, like not animated, like people movie, real people movie. Legally Blonde is my favorite. You know what? Yeah, it is. It's Legally Blonde and Princess Diaries.
I
Oh my
like
God.
Princess
Like
Diaries.
also Confessions of a Teenage Drama Queen. They're
I
all
haven't
like,
seen that movie in a while. I used to love that movie.
listen, I remember watching that movie for the first time because my nickname is Lola. My family called me Lola. And when her name was fucking Lola, I fucking literally had a stroke. I was like, oh my God. And then I came back to life and I was like, I'm not a liar, but that's me. I didn't live in the city, but that's me.
My favorite line from that movie is, I'm a flamingo in a flock of pigeons.
Yes.
That's like my favorite line ever. I just love that line so much. It's so over the top.
As a child, were you Lindsay or were you Hillary? Like, who's your girl?
I don't know if I had a preference, honestly. Like, I kind of was just like, whatever.
Really? I didn't have a preference. I liked them both. But when it came, because like they both did movies with like Chad Michael Murray, I did prefer Lindsay's movie.
What movies? Oh, like Another Cinderella Story
Story of
or
Freaky
A
Friday.
Freaky Friday. I listen to the soundtrack of Freaky Friday way too
All
much.
the time. Me too.
Way too much.
Don't
Like,
want to grow up. I want to get out. Oh my God. All the time.
it's
I
so awkward. Like, I'll be in my car jamming to it. I'm like, how old is this song? How old am
don't
I at
know.
this point?
I don't give a fuck. I'm like, away, away. I love that. That's my favorite scene in that movie. When it's,
When they're rocking in the car.
No, when it's Jamie Lee Curtis
Oh,
playing the
and she's
guitar,
singing.
and it's Lindsay, but it's not really Lindsay. It's they switch bodies. Spoiler
That's so
alert
funny.
for those of you who haven't seen it. I'm sure
Right. But in
everyone
case you don't know what Freaky Friday is.
has. You know what? I lied right now. I realized that Legally Blonde is my second favorite movie. Clueless is my first favorite movie. I apologize.
I am probably going to get killed for this, but I don't think I've ever seen Clueless in its entirety.
How? Bobby Paul Rudd? Dottie? Zaddy Paul Rudd? You didn't watch that movie? He falls in love with his stepsister? Wow. They're not married. The parents are not married anymore, so it's not weird. But Paul Rudd? And his youth? Looking exactly like he looks like an Ant-Man? No difference? No aging?
I know he has not aged a single fucking day, but no,
Right.
I don't think I've actually seen that movie in its entirety.
The fashion? Love it. Love the fashion in that movie. Oh my God. My sister's older than I am, my sister Grace. So, like, she used to always watch it because, like, she was in her prime when that movie came out. I was, like, a little too young, but since she watched it all the time, I did as well.
Okay.
And,
Maybe
my
that's why I
ass right
didn't watch
there.
it.
Bitch, premium content. Her dad reminds me of your dad. You have to watch the movie. Her dad is your dad.
Oh God, okay. I'll have to watch okay. that. All right.
Like you, her dad and your dad have the same vibe, and I love her dad, and I love your dad. I love Daddy Frey. So you have to watch the movie.
All right. Like
with Eric. With Eric. Okay.
No, not with Eric. Not with Eric.
Eric will probably hate it.
Grandma, I have been eating. And she was like, okay, just wanted to make sure. She called me every day.
To make sure you're eating.
She's like, did you eat today? And I'm like, yeah. She's like, what?
That's funny.
Well, I ate this and this.
I think my grandma does that too, though. Not every day, but my grandma, when I call my grandma's like, oh, what did you eat today?
No, every day. And then my grandma buys me things. Like, she bought me collagen and she bought me these raisins. And I'll be like, yeah, I ate some cereal. Did you put the raisins that I bought you in the cereal? No, why not? So I just waste money. I'm like, no, I eat them sometimes. And then like, if I do tell her, like the other day I lied and was like, oh yeah, I put your raisins in the cereal because I knew she was gonna. And she's like, don't put too many, don't eat the raisins too much because you're gonna get constipated. I'm like, what the fuck?
Oh my God, that's funny.
And then I was like, fine, grandma, I won't eat the raisins tomorrow. And she's like, okay, good.
My grandma does without food. She'll do, she'll buy me like a shirt. Like she bought me like this really nice black, like Calvin Klein shirt that had like these gold like things on it. Mm-hmm. And she was like, when are you going to wear it? And I'm like, I don't know. Whenever I decide to wear it, like, I don't have any specific day of the week that I'm going to wear this shirt. So then I wore this shirt when I had went to, when I had gone to the Louvre, I wore it. And I took a picture and I sent it to her and she was like, oh, that's such a nice shirt. Where'd you get it? I'm like, bitch, you got it for me. Like, you asked me, like, she would literally ask me like once every like 2 months. Oh, did you wear the shirt that I got you? Did you wear the shirt that I got you? And I'd be like, oh yeah, I wore it. Well, you never sent me a picture. And so I finally wear it and send her a picture. And she's like, well, that's a nice shirt. Where'd you get it? And like, I know she doesn't remember that she bought it. I'm like, but you bought it for me. She's like, oh really? That must be why I like it so much.
How are you?
I am so great. Everything is wonderful. That's sarcasm. It's good. It's going, you know, nothing crazy.
Are you ready for my wedding? Almost, like literally a month away.
Shit. Honestly, it's not going to hit me until like 2 weeks before.
I'm like nervous, not nervous like to marry Josh because like, bitch, we're already married, but like I'm nervous. I keep having this reoccurring dream that like someone stole my money and I can't pay for the wedding, even though it's almost paid for. Like it's pretty much paid for. Like I don't know why. Oh, also I'm nervous because, and I know you were nervous about it too, like getting your dress hemmed, like they won't give me a price.
Oh,
like we have to see it, and I'm like, I'm a numbers driven person, like you need to tell me how
like,
much
it give is. Me an estimate, like it could like give me a like a price range that way I
that's
know
what I said. I was like, it's a hem, like, and I have two dresses, so I like
right and they know the dress because you bought the dress from them, like it's not like they can't pull it up and be like, oh that's right, you bought dress 1234A and you need to have it hemmed and it has three layers, so that's gonna be $75 for, you know, all three layers or something like that.
Because technically for your dress, it's going to be around $65 and they're doing a lot more than just hemming it.
Right. $65, $75. They're taking it in and they're hemming it.
And they're fixing your boobie area.
Oh, thank God, because I'm struggling up there. The itty bitty titty committee.
Speaking of titties, my grandma was telling me to, I talked to her before I talked to you today. She was complaining about how big her boobs are.
Does she want to share? Like, I don't understand, like, why everyone in your family just has these, like, tiggle bitties, and I'm over here, like, suffering. Because in my family, too, like, some of my aunts have some tiggle bitties, and I'm just like, okay, well, what happened to me? Like, where did they go?
Listen to what my grandma was saying. She was like, you know, Liza, with age, like, I don't feel like my boobs are sagging. Like, what's going on? Like, she wants them to sag, because she thinks they'll look smaller. She's like, they're, like, perky. And I'm like, oh my God, grandma.
Your grandma's too fucking much.
Literally telling me. And then I'm like, well, grandma, you know,
like that, like, why are you complaining?
Yeah. And I was like, she has D's, which I feel like are decent boobs. And I was like, well, you know, I'm a triple D. And she's like, yeah, we're right there. And I was like, well, no, because you're a D and I'm a triple D. And she's like, no, we're right there.
Like, no, like, you're wrong. We are like the same size.
Yeah. And then she, because I'm a 34 triple D and she's a 38 D. And she was like, oh my God.
Well, she has like a wider back. Honestly, if her back were smaller, she probably would have bigger boobs than you.
Yeah. No, my boobs are bigger than hers.
You think so? Because it goes by how wide you are and stuff too. So like,
yeah, but remember that, I've tried on my grandma's bras before. They don't fit me. My grandma has smaller boobs than me. Mm. Yeah, she does. Also my boobs are like full in every capacity, you know?
Yeah.
Like some people have like flat boobs on top or flat boobs on the bottom or side. They don't really have much side boobs. My boobs are just full all around. Yeah, you know, it's like just a fucking full circle. And my grandma's are not. So hers have always been smaller because like when I was younger, she was a C.
Huh.
It was my mom who had like huge boobs who had to get operated when she was a teenager. And so did my older sister, but like not me. All right, what's your random thought? Because I think you have a random thought.
I do have a random thought. It's actually more of like a random
statement.
Random anger towards everything. Not really everything.
Oh, so it's a random rant.
A random rant, I guess.
That's a good one. Random rant.
All right. I don't understand why everything is fucking closed on Mondays. Everything is closed on Mondays. I don't know why. I don't know who thought that was a good idea, but it's not a good idea. I wanted to go out to eat yesterday, right?
Mm-hmm.
The restaurant I wanted to go to. Closed on Mondays. All right, cool. Well, let's look for another restaurant. Oh, closed on Mondays. Oh, closed on Mondays. Everything is closed on Mondays.
Really?
Do you not have that? Maybe it's because I live in the middle of nowhere. Everything is closed on Mondays and it's so irritating.
Maybe it's like, are they like mom and pop restaurants? Like smaller
some restaurant. Yeah, because like I like to support like smaller businesses, you know that. And it was like this noodle place, and because Eric wasn't feeling good, I was like, why don't we go get ramen? And he's like, okay, we can go get ramen. And
where is that at? In Lidditz?
Yeah. And I was like, let's go get ramen. And so we're going and we pass this one place, and it's like, oh, they're closed on Mondays. He's like, oh, is the place we're going to open on Mondays? I didn't remember it being open on Mondays. And I was like, I'm pretty sure it's open on Mondays. And I was like, shit, why don't we, like, because we were going to the movie theater and it's right there. I was like, why don't we look it up? And as soon as we pull it up, it's fucking closed on Mondays. And I was like, well, damn it.
Well, they have to be closed at least, like, they need a day off. So that's the reason they do it, because I'm sure they're open Sundays.
Which is dumb.
Yeah, I think restaurants like that, it's because most people like have off Sundays. So most people go out to eat on Sundays, and then Mondays, everybody normally works, you know?
I still think it's dumb.
Not you.
I still think lucky. It's dumb.
You're one of the lucky ones who doesn't work on Mondays. I wish.
I don't work Mondays. I love that. That's like one of my favorite things about my schedule is that I don't work Mondays.
Yeah, because then you don't have like Mondays, because those are the worst.
They are the worst.
Like Sundays are like so bittersweet. They're like so great, but then like so bad towards the end, like so bad, you know, because you're like, oh my God, it's 6 o'clock. I got to go to sleep soon because I have to work tomorrow. Ugh.
Yeah, no, I agree. I do always hate that, but I do love Monday. I do love having Mondays off, I should say. Maybe that's why I'm so mad about it. It's because I have Mondays off.
Yeah, most people don't. So like, that's why I didn't realize.
I want you to like look now. I want you to like go on Grubhub on Monday or whatever. You use Grubhub, you use DoorDash, whatever you use. DoorDash. And I want you to.
The ones that I use, they're not closed.
Well, I want you to look, but just to scroll to see what's like how little is open on Monday.
Okay. Because like Salad Works never closed. So.
Ugh. I don't have a Salad Works. Like
Cold Stone. Mm-hmm. So I'm not having, I haven't had Cold Stone in a while. Never closed. So that's all I'm saying. I mean, they close like at 9, but.
I haven't been to Cold Stone in a while. My grandma gave me a gift card for Cold Stone. And I haven't gone in a while. I need to go. I love Cold Stone.
Let me tell you that the other day, it was Josh's birthday. I got him.
I wanted to ask you what you guys did for his birthday.
So we just ordered food. He didn't want to go out anywhere. He's like, I don't want to go anywhere. So he loves the chicken and waffles from Chili's. I I'm not a Chili's fan, but we got Chili's. The ribs weren't actually that bad this time. So whatever, we had Chili's, and then I got him a cake.
I saw the cake. I saw the cake online, actually.
Actually, that was last year's birthday, not this year's.
Oh.
I didn't take a video this year because, like, when I got home, I went to the bathroom, I came out, half the cake was gone.
Okay.
But last year, it was, like, the pandemic, and I went and bought the cake. Like, I picked the cake. And I am a selfish person, and I always get the cake that I like, which is marble with buttercream. Josh is not a huge fan of buttercream. He likes whipped, but I absolutely hate whipped icing. I don't like it. I don't want it. But this year, he got whipped, so I didn't get a piece of cake, which at the end of the day worked out for me because, like, you know, I'm on the road to fitness, I guess. Also, Josh was like, how come our wedding cake's not whipped? Because it's not. Like, you can't have a wedding cake with whipped icing.
Mm.
Like, it, you know, they use buttercream or fondant because it's hard. Like, it's harder. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm like, shut up. And he's like, well, you could have done the filling whip. Nope. I didn't. I didn't.
There'll be so many other desserts that he won't even care.
Yeah, we found out he's not allergic to brownies, two people. I knew he wasn't allergic to brownies.
He thought he was allergic to brownies?
Yeah, I thought I told you this. I did tell you this a while ago, and you were like, oh, he can't eat brownies? Yuck.
That doesn't make any fucking sense.
Yeah, apparently when he was young, he had an allergic reaction to brownies, so then he's been depriving himself of brownies for his whole life.
But does he not know what a brownie is? Does he not realize that a brownie is just like a dense chocolate cake?
Yeah, whatever. And I keep saying that there must have been something in the brownies.
Like nuts or something.
Like, he's not allergic to nuts unless it's like walnuts, but peanuts he's not allergic to.
Wait, he's allergic to walnuts?
I don't know. I'm saying maybe. He never has, you know, like he doesn't like, never try to eat them. Like he doesn't go out, oh, let me eat a walnut or something, you know?
I love walnuts.
So I'm guessing in brownies, what do you normally put in there? Either peanuts or walnuts, you know? Because he's not allergic walnuts, to chocolate.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
So it had to be you ate a brownie with walnuts. If the brownie gave you an allergic reaction, it can't be. And like to me, it's like, it couldn't be the brownie, but he swore it was the brownie. But his little brother was here, JJ, and he loves like those little Debbie brownies.
Uh-huh.
So we had a bunch of them, but also I bought him a pack of the M&Ms. They have new M&Ms where it's like M&M, but the inside is brownie.
Okay.
And I made them sundaes, and Josh, I didn't put the M&Ms in it. And he took the M&Ms and put them in the sundae and was eating the M&Ms.
But
and I was like, what are you eating? What are you crunching on? And he was like, the M&Ms. And I'm like, they have brownies in them. And he was like, oh my God. And I was like, shut up. You feel fine. And he's like, I do feel fine. And we gave it an hour and he was fine. And then I was like, go eat a brownie, a little Debbie's brownie. And he did. And nothing happened. And then I made brownies. Like, I made homemade brownies.
And nothing.
And he ate them. And nothing happened. And I was like, wow. You destroyed your life. You fucking destroyed your life. You know how many times you could have been eating brownies instead of, like, honestly, brownies are more superior than cake. Like, brownies and ice cream hit way different than cake and ice cream.
I do love brownies.
So, he ruined his life. That's all I'm saying. Okay, bitch. I'm ready to get into this Black Widow recap.
Oh my God. Okay, let's go. All right.
Spoilers.
Oh yeah.
This is now, if you're listening and you did not watch Black Widow, you have 30 seconds.
Don't give them 30 seconds. You got like 5 seconds to
log off. And
to log off.
Come back. But come back when you watched it.
Yeah. It's hard to give like a review without, I mean, like there's a review that you can give without giving it away. But at the same time, like, there's too much to talk about. Yeah, there's too much to talk about. So just come back when you're ready.
Okay, let's start off by, what do you rate the movie?
I liked it.
Okay, give me a rating.
Okay, so are we rating it on just it being, like, just the movie? Or are we rating it, why don't we rate it just a movie and then as, like, an MCU movie? Does that make sense? Because, like, you know, like, an MCU movie and how it fits into like the timeline is different than just like how watchable, like how the movie was.
Okay, fine.
All right. As a, like, just as a movie, I'm going to give it like just an 8 out of 10.
Oh, all right.
Obviously you feel different.
8 out of 10. All right.
All right. And as for like an MCU movie, I don't give it as high of a rating. I'm probably going to say about a 6.5, 7 out of 10, okay. Which is still good, but it's not as good.
Yeah. Because Marvel movies are normally like 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
9 out of 10, you know?
Yeah. I mean,
12 out of 10. That's personal preference.
All right. So what did you give? What did you give Black Widow as a regular movie rating?
Okay. I watched it twice because the first time I fell a fucking sleep.
Oh my God. Okay.
Oh my God.
I didn't like actually fall asleep, but I was like dozing off.
So I'm guessing you watched it at home. You didn't watch it in the theater.
Yeah, Josh didn't want to go to the theater. And his dad bought it on Disney Plus and we did like a group watch thing, which was pretty cool.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. So I watched it at home, but I mean, my TV is like 75 inches. Like, it's pretty,
There's just something about watching a Marvel movie in theaters, especially in IMAX. And it just like, it's like an incredible, like different kind of feeling. Ugh. Okay, go ahead. What did you rate it?
So my rating for the movie overall was a 6.
Okay.
The rating for the MCU was a 7.
Really? Okay, so
like that dumbass bitch in the end, I was like, what the fuck is this bitch doing popping up here from Seinfeld? Go back to fucking Seinfeld when nobody watches you. I'm sick of that girl. I thought it was me. I saw purple and I was like, it was Agatha all along. And it wasn't. I was pissed. Like, what the fuck is Agatha? Where's Agatha?
Could you imagine if Agatha just kind of like swooped in and was like, it was Agatha all along. I swear she's
honestly, it would have been a 10 out of 10 then, right? No, don't lie to me. If that shit, that would have made your rating go up. Don't lie.
Oh my God, it would have died of laughter. It would have been so out of context. It would have been like so, like it would not have fit in there, but I would have loved it.
You know, I would have been dead. I saw her, I was like, this dumb bitch. Because I obviously do not like
what's her name?
Wannabe Captain America. Oh. Her name is Julia Louis-Dreyfus or something like that. The lady who plays.
Yeah. I think it's going to be interesting to see her in the MCU, like at like her character just like develop, because she's like very sassy and like kind of cruel, but I'm excited to see her character because
get away from Yelena. I loved Yelena.
Why did you give it a 6? What didn't you like about it?
Okay, so I just felt like the movie was too little too late, like JoJo, you know, like I made peace with Nat being dead.
But you didn't like Nat, right?
Not that I didn't like her. She wasn't my least favorite Avenger. Who's my least favorite Avenger? Let me think.
Hawkeye.
No.
Really? I thought Hawkeye was like your least favorite Avenger.
No. I like Hawkeye because I like his family story dynamic.
Okay.
Like, I can appreciate a good family man. Very much on Hawkeye's side when Loki fucked him up. I know you feel differently.
Oh, no. I think Loki did horrible, horrible things. And I agree that he was a bad guy. However, I just love his character.
Okay. Couldn't relate then. Can relate now. So I do like Hawkeye. I think he brings a nice, just a nice thing to the Avengers. Like most of them are like, you know, good looking single men. His wife is not annoying as fuck. Pepper. Like, fuck off, bitch. I can't stand her when she's calling him like, what are you doing? What do you want him to do? If you don't save the world, you're going to die. So you want to die or you want him to save the world? Let me know. Because like, goddamn. Anyway, but I understand why she was doing, but she was still fucking annoying. Anyway, my least favorite Avenger is going to be very controversial.
Oh, God.
His name is Spider-Man. Okay. Not for me. I like all of the Avengers. Just not for me. I liked it more. I liked Spider-Man more when he was Tobey Maguire, I think. Like, I liked him as a character more. And then you know, he just came in as a kid, and I know he's a kid in the comics, but, you know, he's the least person I have a connection to in the Avengers. I'll say that.
Okay.
Not Hawkeye. Hawkeye is second. No, not second. And then Hawkeye. Oh, wait a minute. No, I changed my mind. This is how Disney is fucking me up. Like, MCU is fucking me up. Because first, my least favorite one was Vision. Because I was like, I don't give a fuck about Vision. But then WandaVision came out. And I was like, wow, I give a fuck about Vision. You know what I mean? So, like, next episode, we're going to create a list. Because actually, I don't know anymore. I'm just guessing it's still Spider-Man. But that shit can change after Spider-Man.
And the No Way Home. Yeah. Spider-Man and the Multiverse of Madness. I'm just like mixing everything together now.
Yeah. But I always want to say Doctor Strange has always been top five for me.
Really?
Love me some Doctor Strange. First of all, he fucking looks like a magician. For some reason, I fuck with that heavily. I just like Doctor Strange and I like his name, Benedict Cumberbatch. I don't know. I just have a connection with him.
Okay. You
know? So right. He is top five. But right. I just felt like the movie was too little too late for me. I made peace with Nat dying. I appreciated her after she gave herself and died. I just thought she was a hero. I was like, bitch, you a hero.
I think that was like the biggest thing that almost everybody said was that it was too, like, they waited too long to release this movie. Like, you should have, like, it should have been like a phase one, a phase two movie. Mostly a phase one. And even if you didn't do it as a phase one, you could have done it when it was supposed to come out, like
in between
Civil War and Infinity War. Like, it would have, I think it would have made that transition premium. A lot better.
1,000%. That shit would have been premium. But then they couldn't have put that spoiler alert at the end.
Yeah, but they would have found something else. They would have added like a Thor Ragnarok scene or something. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I agree. Like, I think it was very out of place. I had already made peace. I didn't care. Like, I didn't care.
Yeah.
Though I do appreciate the story. I love that she gave me this, her sister. Her sister's hilarious. Elena. I loved Elena. I love when she fucking made fun of her in her stance. I was like, bitch, I always thought that. Yes. I love when she gave her the best. I loved the dad, like the fake dad.
Alexi. Yo, yeah. He killed me.
He was backing me up. Always have loved Black Widow's fighting scenes. Her fighting scenes, her Captain America, one of my favorite fighting scenes because they actually do like
hand-to-hand combat. Yeah.
Love that shit. I thought it was an okay movie. It just too little too late. Like, I feel like if that shit would have came out when it should have came out, I would have been a huge Black Widow stan. Like, my ass would have been like, she's a badass, I'm a badass, she could fight, I think I could fight, we're gonna fucking join up and make a team and fuck everybody up, we're gonna fuck Thanos up, we don't need Thor, we don't need Captain America, we want him there but we don't need him,
right?
And then, like, the only thing the movie made me a little bit upset was like, why Captain America and Nat didn't end up together? Like, now I'm like, why didn't they end up together?
I haven't read very many I haven't read many comics. Is that right? Is that good English? I don't know. But the only comics that I've really read, I've read some Deadpool comics and I've read some, I've read one Ant-Man comic and I've read some Spider-Gwen comics. Mm-hmm. However, from what I understand, Black Widow actually was in a relationship for a long time with Bucky.
No.
I was actually like, what? I was actually really here for that. I'm actually, apparently, like, it's a really good story. I forgot what comic like series it's in, but I'm going to find it and I'm going to send it to you because I want to read it. I know you're like, absolutely not.
No, because I want Bucky to date Sarah. You know, Sarah.
I don't. I mean, I'm here for that too. But I guess for like for the comics, like unrelated to the MCU. Like,
You feel like Captain America and
no, like, because Captain America is
underlining like flirtation a little bit.
She's flirted with everybody though. You know what I mean? Like, that's just who she is as a person. Like, I think she's just extremely flirty.
I like her in Hulk.
No.
Yes.
I did not like it. Took her, it made her really awkward around him. And I didn't like that because she is such a strong female character.
I didn't like that either, but I like that she calmed him. Like, she was the only person who can calm him down when he was Hulk. Like, I thought that was cute.
I mean, Thor tried it too, and it kind of worked.
Well, bitch, Thor's a god, you know. I mean, we established that earlier in the show when I said, you know, he was having a concert in the middle of the night. That's with true. A thunder.
But I don't know. So, see, I really liked the movie. I thought the movie by itself was like really good. I agree, like, she has quite possibly some of the best like fight scenes like ever.
Though in the white outfit, iconic. She looks so beautiful.
Oh my god, I was a little confused by a few things in the outfit. Why her costume fit so tight while her sister Elena's was like extremely baggy and loose.
Yeah, I don't
know, like, either. Again, over sexualizing her and nobody else. But then, like, when her was it Melina, her mother, quote unquote, when she was in the suit, it fit tight too. But I don't know, that part annoyed me a little.
I think they were mirroring. That didn't annoy me because I thought, and, you know, this could just be me, you know, having a deep, looking into a meaning that isn't true. But I thought it was like her and her sister have such different personalities. And really, yeah, like the way she wore, like the jacket, the vest, the way her sister wore it, she had looser clothes on with it. The way Black Widow wore it, I mean, everything was tight, super tight. So I think it's like, and sisters, I feel like there's always like a really girly, sexy one, and then there's one who don't give a F and, you know, it's kind of tomboyish or not as sexy as it was. But I can see why you thought they over-sexualized her. But that's what she's known for, though.
Which is unfortunate that that's kind of what she's known for. But
I agree.
I don't know. I liked it. I thought it was good. I liked the callback at the end. When she was like, thank you so much for your cooperation. I was like, yes, bitch. Yes, finally. Yes,
I did like that too.
I thought that was great.
He was my least favorite villain.
Yeah, because you didn't see him. Like, he was a behind the scenes villain that didn't, like, I don't know.
No, but like what he did, like.
Yeah, I know. He, like, I want to say, like, the whole thing was like, when oh, she it's supposed
him
to be up,
I was like, god damn. And then they made him Cuban. I was like, bitch, why you have to make him Cuban? Like, now I root for him just a little bit.
Oh my god.
Not really. He's like, you know, I'm here for Latinos. And I'm like, why is the first Latino in your, I'm thinking it's no Zoe Saldana.
Yeah.
Is Latina, but like, we don't have a lot of Latino representation in TVs. Why you made him the bad guy? And I didn't like the what they did to the Taskmaster. I don't like that shit. I don't like how he, that's supposed to be like a really hard character to take down, like, wasn't supposed to be a girl, which, you know, I can appreciate you trying to make it a girl. I didn't like that twist.
I thought it was I understand why they did it. Like, they, I get it. They tried to like clear her conscience, kind of, because like her entire like adult life outside of the Black Widow program, she's always had this quote unquote like red on her ledger. And the only real thing that she ever felt really bad for was for killing his daughter, and then find out that his daughter's not actually dead. Like, she's still alive and she can possibly help her.
Yeah. I mean, I guess so, but she's like, no offense, she's dead already. So cool. You want to clear her conscience. I just think, I thought Taskmaster was going to be in the MCU world a lot more, but I don't think
it will. No, I don't think so. I think it was like a once and done thing. I mean, who knows?
The concept of a villain, because it mimics everything you do. Like, when it had the Black Panther nails, when it, like, you know, it's.
Yeah.
It's a like, hard villain. You're fighting against yourself, pretty much.
Right. So you have to, like, think outside of the box a bit. I felt like they underused the Taskmaster.
Oh,
like,
1,000%.
Like, I felt like they could have had more scenes with her. Like with her fighting or just like even just being there a little bit more, showing more of, like, they only showed that one scene of kind of like what she does, like how she like how she just watches videos of people fighting and then just can mimic them, like didn't show anything else. But
I would have liked to see like the training, like how does she go down so quick? Like, no offense, Black Widow's a great fighter, but she has no powers.
Well, she deactivated her helmet, and her helmet, I think, is what, like, kind of controls her. Like, kind of how they had that spray or that...
But it was too easy. You don't think it was too easy?
I think it was easy. I definitely do.
Like I think, from one of the bigger villains, like, you know, like... Really hard.
Yeah, that shit was easy. I think that the main villain of the story was supposed to be Dreykov.
All right.
I think. Like, I think that that's what they kind of imagine. Like, it was like a villain and a sub, like a main villain and then like the sub villain.
Mm-hmm. We'll see if they introduce her. I just feel like it was like they could have fought and maybe, I think it would have been better if they fought and then she like left.
Like, she got away.
Yeah, she got away. Because then they could have, they introduced her and could have, like, really made her into a badass.
And brought her back, to, yeah.
To other movies. Because I think Josh said that the Taskmaster also goes against Spider-Man, which would have made sense. But, like, she's free now. So,
yeah. So, well, yeah, now she's with all the other widows and doing God, so like, doing what? One of the big complaints that I heard... and I also agree with about the movie was that they finally give Black Widow her own movie just to introduce her, like her successor.
Yeah. I like her sister. Don't get me wrong. I was,
oh no, I think her sister was great. Like, I thought it was like a really great, like, dynamic. A lot of people say that they really liked her. Like, they watched while watching the movie, they found themselves enjoying more scenes with Florence Pugh. However, I really enjoyed, you know, I liked the Black Widow. I like her character. I think she's a cool character overall. But I do agree that I don't think they, like, that was like the best approach. Like, oh, I'm just gonna, here's how my story, by the way, like, here's my actual family that I kind of grew up with for a few years. And here's a little bit more about me and how, like, I was trained and, you know, what's going on with that. Oh, and here's my younger sister and she's gonna take over for me now because I'm dead. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk.
Yeah, I mean, I just... The movie wasn't for me.
Okay, that's fair. Will you... Okay, so how rewatchable is it for you? Like, will you rewatch it?
No. Like, I did a second time just for this...
Because you also didn't finish it because you were falling asleep.
Yeah, I did finish it, but I was, like, dozing off in parts. I just feel like too little too late. Maybe, you know what? Maybe I would watch it, but then no, because it makes no sense because of that end scene credit.
But you don't need to watch that end scene credit. That end scene credit is like 2 minutes long. Like, I feel like I would rewatch that, like rewatching like the whole MCU. If I actually watched that after watching Civil War, think I would like it a lot more.
Okay, so... There are certain movies in the MCU that I watch for pure entertainment. Like, yeah. All of them, minus this one. And maybe the first Captain America. No, not even then. I do watch the first Captain America for entertainment. Oh, you know what movies I don't watch for entertainment? Iron Man 2 and 3.
Oof. Iron Man 3 was not good. Yeah. I don't even remember Iron Man 2.
I don't either. Like, I do and I don't, like, you know?
Yeah.
So, unless I'm, like, wanting to rewatch the MCU in story sequence, I will not just pop on that movie for pure entertainment.
I definitely think they were very late with making this movie. And I do think it was a great movie. I think that's why I gave it such a low MCU rating, was because... had it came out when it was like in theory, like when in the movie it says it came out, or when it was supposed to come out, like 2018, like if it had come out actually at that time around Civil War, I think it would have been a lot better. I think when we lost Natasha, we would have even had, like, we would have felt more for her. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I agree.
And I think that that's where.
And I felt a lot for her at that moment. Like when.
Oh, I did.
That's why I think, like, Hawkeye is not my least favorite, because he's just like. Like the relationship between him and Nat was just so cute and so beautiful that they both were fighting to die. Like, bitch, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'll push you in. I'm not giving myself, you know.
Yeah.
I'm not pushing you in. I'm like, you want to go? All right, good for you. Like, you know, like there's very little people who would want to sacrifice themselves to die. And they loved each other so much that they both were like, no, you live, no, you live, no, you live. I'd be like, no, you're right. I live, right?
Yeah.
I live. So I just think that that gave me so much respect for her that I didn't need the movie to give me even more of a respect for her. Like, my respect for her after that movie was just sky high, like sky high that she gave herself up for a whole world. Like, goddamn, she's the best Avenger. Like, she's the purest hearted Avenger, no matter what she did in her past or whatever. That shit don't matter to me. She made that shit up. So I didn't need the movie. I didn't need it. I didn't need to. Her troubled past, like, that shit just makes me sadder. And what she gave us, we didn't deserve, period. And it was either sooner or don't do it at all. They could have done a movie where, like, she went to go help her sister and introduced her sister that way or something. I didn't need to know the backstory. I'm glad she killed the villain that she wanted to kill. Like, I'm all fine and dandy, but, like, you're dead now, and now that just is fucking annoying, you know.
Yeah, I can see what you're saying.
They dropped the ball a little bit with this one. Though I'm glad we got a movie. Bitch, you would have preferred if it was Spider-Man No Way Home.
I don't know. I think in order, yes. Like, had we gotten Natasha's story, like I said, like Natasha's story before, and then this just have been another Spider-Man movie, I probably would have been like, yay, Spider-Man. However, I really do like her character, and I kind of wanted to see which way they were going to take her.
Yeah, but they weren't answering any of our questions. Like, I want answers. This gave me no answers other than, like, you're setting up the Hawkeye show. And let me let you know, Yelena, if you don't wake the fuck up, if you touch Black Hawkeye, I'll fucking kill you. Don't touch him. Don't fucking touch him. I like you, but don't touch him or nobody in his family. All right? That's what I'm saying. So I just need, you know, I have so many questions from, like, WandaVision and the multiverse, and then he's Spider-Man, you know?
So I guess this was supposed to come out before the shows did.
But they made a mistake postponing it. They made a mistake. Because compared to WandaVision, sorry, this movie is trash. Compared to WandaVision, like.
I wouldn't say, I don't know if I'd say
Jessica.
That.
Compared to Loki, this movie is trash. Compared to Captain America, the Winter Soldier and Captain America, the Falcon, this movie is trash. Jessica. WandaVision, the spoilers we got, it was Agatha all along. Come on. This movie was trash compared to that. Sorry.
I don't know.
I'm not saying it's trash. I gave it a 6 and then a 7. It's not trash, but compared to how good those shows were, the movie does not compare, and that's why people the ratings are lower, because our expectations are now higher because of how good the shows are. Maybe it seems like they put more care in the men's movies than the female movies. Not trying to make it a gender thing, but, like, I fucking hate it. I didn't hate it. I just wasn't into the Captain Marvel movie either.
I didn't mind Captain Marvel. I liked Captain Marvel.
Maybe it was the actors who played her, like. No, not for me.
Yeah, I liked Captain Marvel. I won't say it's, like, my favorite movie. I've rewatched it a few times. I can see why people don't like it, but she's literally the same, like, as any of the male characters, but she's a woman, and I think that's why a lot of people don't like it.
Who? Captain Marvel?
Like, she has that, like, I don't want to say arrogant, but very, like, confident, like self-confidence that like, I don't know, Tony Stark had that same self-confidence. Thor had that same like arrogant self-confidence. And then they get knocked down a few levels. She didn't really get knocked down a few levels. She just kind of got like a little bit, she got like the sense knocked into her kind of thing. Like she like realized what was actually going on.
Yeah, I just feel like they didn't make her as badass as like they should have. And I don't think it's her fault. I also just don't like the actress that plays like Brie Larson. I'm just like, you know, I'm like, not excited, not happy. Like, I don't know. But like, maybe she'll grow on me. She literally was in one-fourth movies, you know, like.
Yeah.
Change it up completely. And I need a movie by Agatha. I need an Agatha movie tomorrow.
Okay.
My ass needs that movie. I need an Agatha all along. It was Agatha. Wouldn't that be interesting, an Agatha movie?
I don't think I'd like, we already got her story. You know what I mean? Like they gave enough of her story in WandaVision.
Fine.
Like
I'm not opposed.
Huh?
I'm not opposed to an Agatha story.
I mean, if it came out, I'd watch it. Like, don't get me wrong. I'd watch it. Do I need it? No. Okay. So, how are you excited for the last episode of Loki?
No, I'm not that excited. I don't want it to end.
But are you excited to like have are you excited to have another episode of Loki then?
Yes. Bittersweet. Because like, what do we get next? Hawkeye?
No, next I think is Shang-Chi and the Ten Rings.
I'm not that excited about that.
I don't know much about the character.
Does this have anything to do with Doctor Strange?
I'm not sure. I don't know. I think it might. Like, some of it looks very similar to, like, the magic that they use in Doctor Strange. However, I don't know. I'm
getting annoyed because I have questions. And, like, instead of getting answers, I'm getting more questions.
Like what?
Like, where the fuck is Wanda?
Wanda is in the middle of nowhere. We're gonna
Why?
Because.
Where's Vision? Where's Captain America? I have so many questions.
I feel like those aren't, like, we know that they're coming back.
Yeah, but I want to know now. What's going on with the multi-universe? Where is Ant-Man?
I mean, it's going to take time.
I understand that, but you're giving me more shows and I'm getting more questions.
That's good though. I think that's what they want.
Like, why the fuck was Thor a little baby in that world, a little thing, and his hammer was there and he was in like a jar?
He was a frog.
He was a frog?
Yes, that was Throg. Or, yeah, that was Throg.
Why? Why do they have animal versions of Thor and Loki?
Because in the comics there is a Throg. Loki in the comics plays a joke on Thor and turns him into a frog and sends him to Earth, and then okay. Thor hangs out with all these frogs in Central Park and take down like this big, like, I forget, they take down a big guy or like a big animal enemy in Central Park, and Thor gets his hammer back. And he, you know, gets sent back to Asgard as a human. Or actually, he doesn't get sent back. He becomes, like, a massive frog. And he becomes, like, Thor the frog. And then apparently, like, some of his hammer, like, chipped. Some of Mjolnir chipped and ended up on the ground. And one of his frog friends becomes worthy and becomes Throg. When Thor comes back to Asgard.
Riddle me this. Will Wanda be a villain or not? We don't know that.
Probably not.
I hope not.
Because I think she already had her like villain arc. I don't think she's going to be considered a villain. I don't know. Who knows? I think that she's going to unleash another villain, is my theory. She's going to accidentally do something like that. And then Doctor Strange is going to kind of fix
and
that.
And where is Mephisto? I heard him so much. And now I hear nothing.
I don't think Mephisto is coming.
How sad.
I don't think Mephisto is coming. I think we're going to get Kang the Conqueror, though, but I don't think we're getting Mephisto.
Okay. All right. I'm just ready to watch Spider-Man because I want to see all three Spider-Mans.
I wonder if they're actually, I hope they do actually have all three of them. Like, the rumors have been that there's going to be all three of them in there.
Well, they saw them on set. Google it.
I don't want to because I don't want any spoilers.
Okay. Well, I saw them on set and I got really excited because I'm like, I just feel like that's so fucking cool. Don't you think? Like, all three fucking Spider-Mans, like, are, it's like our worlds. Because, like, when we watch the movie, like, we know all three Spider-Mans, but they don't.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be interesting for sure on how they do that. How that comes across.
I just feel like the multiverse is going to be, it's very intriguing to me, the multiverse.
Yeah, I'm it's definitely going to be interesting. I want to see how they do it, like how they handle it. And I want to know what happens with the fucking Skrulls. I know they're part of the Secret Invasion series that we're going to be getting, but I want to know how many people were actually Skrulls this entire time.
Yes, me too. Oh my god, me too. I just feel like that's very interesting.
But like, I want to know, like, because they had Nick Fury like as a Skrull at I keep saying it, I feel like I'm saying it so weird, I don't know why. Okay, well, I in my head it sounds weird.
Okay.
But like, he was, you know, in space the entire time with everything that was going on in Spider-Man Far From Home. Mm-hmm. And it's like her because it was what, Maria Hill and Nick Fury, they were both Skrulls, and then Nick Fury was in space. So it's like, okay, well, who else is just hanging out in space?
Yeah, that's a good question. That's what I'm saying. That's more intriguing than a story that we all kind of knew in Black Widow.
Yeah.
So again, respect to her. The movie changed nothing for me. Like, I still think that she's the most selfless Avenger, and I'm so thankful for her saving the world, me included, because, you know, I'm part of the world. So, like, you know.
Oh, have you ever done that quiz, that, like, Russian roulette, where if, when... did you survive Thanos snap?
No, but did you ever take the test about like which Avenger you are?
No.
On BuzzFeed?
No. What?
Oh my god, it takes like 2 seconds. Like, take it.
Hold on.
Literally take it.
Okay.
I'm about to take it.
Okay, I got my character.
You didn't get mine yet.
Wait, which one did you take?
It's on Marvel.com. The first one that popped up.
Oh, I took the BuzzFeed one.
Oh, it's okay. It's the same thing, I think.
Okay. I mean, we got very different questions.
Mm-hmm. Mine are like more geared towards men. It's like, what did you play with as a child? Action figures. I'm like, what the fuck?
Right, here, I'll take the Marvel one real quick.
Just say who you got in BuzzFeed.
Okay, from BuzzFeed?
Yeah, it's fine.
I got the Winter Soldier.
Bitch, you fucking it up. I got I got Thor, of course. Like, bitch, I was a little scared. I was like, my ass is going to get Hulk. Not scared, because I would have been fine with Hulk, because they were kept asking me like, you like to be alone? Yes. Do you have a temper? Yes.
So wait, what's the description say?
Well, this gives you kind of the percentages of who you are.
Oh, okay.
So I was 53% Thor and then 21% Captain America, which, wow. Thank you.
Oh, see, now I feel like I should take that one.
You could. And then I was 14% Black Widow and then 14% Nick Fury.
7%. All right, let me see this one.
7% Hawkeye. But my thing says up a popular and powerful figure. I'm not popular, so wrong. You are often the group organizer, a friend that can be relied upon to always make sure friends get home safe. Sure. I don't have friends, so can't relate. But if I did have friends, possibly. But whatever, I got Thor. Like.
All right, so mine said that I was a Winter Soldier on BuzzFeed, and it said, you've had a rough life, and it's led you to make some decisions you now regret. You may be messed up, but you're a good person who is capable of great things. But I want to do that Marvel one now.
You may send you the link.
I got it here. I pulled it up.
Okay.
Okay. Are you ready for my answer from the Avengers for the Marvel website?
Yeah.
I am 30% Black Widow.
I can see that. Though, I still feel like they're all wrong. You're like 99% Loki.
Probably. I am 30% Black Widow. I am a three-way tied 21% between Thor, Nick Fury, and Hawkeye.
All right.
0% Iron Man, 0% the Hulk, and 7% Captain America.
That's a fucking lie with the Hulk. That's a lie. That's a lie.
I'm going to read to you what this says here about Black Widow and how I'm 30% Black Widow.
Aye.
It says, fiercely independent, your intelligence can come across as intimidating at times. However, you are equipped with the tools to forge your own way in this world and don't really care what people think of you.
You know what I heard about that? That you're a know-it-all and they didn't lie. Because you like know it all. You're a know-it-all. So they didn't lie. You know,
oh my God.
I heard only nothing but truth in that description.
Maybe that's why I liked the movie so much. Maybe that's why, because I felt like it was display, like completely displaying me as a person. I was like, this is me. This is who I am. I am super secretive and super smart and just nobody quite knows how smart I am.
And you like know it all. Like, you know it all. So, okay, I'll let you have that one. You can have that one. I guess you're not Loki. You are. Because I do feel like Loki's kind of a low-key know-it-all, though. There's a difference between knowing a lot and there's a difference between being a know-it-all. Jessica, I know you wouldn't know the difference. But
can't relate.
You, Loki, and Black Widow are know-it-alls. So it doesn't matter if you're on the earth for 1 year or a trillion years, you bitches will act like you know it all. Okay?
Can't relate.
You can relate because that is 100%. Like, that was probably the most relatable thing you will ever hear in your life.
Oh my God.
I'm excited. I'm Thor, bitch. Whatever.
You're ridiculous.
Whatever. I can't wait to get really big in Thor and Love and Thunder and be so strong and, you know.
I honestly am going to be really disappointed if for Halloween this year, you do not go as a Viking or Thor.
Well, I'm not going to be able to because like Josh would want to be Thor and that means I would have to be Jane Foster and no way. Josh doesn't like it when we go, like we would have to be a costume where he's a boy and I'm a girl. Like we can't be two boys. He doesn't like that shit.
Why?
I don't know. I'm like, I want variety in my life. Like, I'm sick and tired.
It's a fucking costume.
I know. I'm like, I'm sick and tired of having a vagina. Like, for one night, can I have a penis? Jesus. God.
God.
He doesn't like it. And I'm like, whatever. Because I, for your party, I wanted to go as Men in Black. Right?
Oh my God, that would have been. But they have a woman, Tessa Thompson was in Men in Black.
No, I refuse to acknowledge that movie. I didn't watch it. That was trash.
I didn't watch it either, but.
It was pretty basura. But I wanted to do the original, and of course, I would have been Will Smith, because, like, who else would I be? I don't know. He would have been the other guy, the old white guy. And he said no. How rude. And he's like, you're a girl, Liza. And I was like, so?
Oh, that would piss me the fuck off.
You know, I had so many great ideas. I was like, wow, why don't we go as Martin? And he was like, oh, you can go as Gina. I was like, no. Why would I go as Gina? I definitely want to be the friend, the moocher friend. I forget his name. He's like, no. And I was like, no.
Oof, that wouldn't happen. So then, I told Eric, you
know, settled.
Me and Eric will like 100% gender bend the shit out of any character. If I'm like, yo, Eric, I want you to go as Black Widow. He'd be like, fucking right. Would he wear a wig? Probably not. I'd want him to go full cosplay as Black Widow, but he would probably wear like a cat suit though.
All right.
Like I would see like, maybe not like, you know,
I mean, he got the body for it, the flat stomach.
I know.
Period.
But
I'm going to have to think of something. I remember earlier this year, I told you that we called dibs on Wanda and Vision.
Oh yeah. No, well, who did me and Eric say we were gonna go as?
But there's so
we
many
said somebody
movies coming
else.
out, so maybe different.
I know. I probably
you and
still
Eric
wanna go
should
as
go as Alexi and the mom.
Oh, and Iron Maiden.
Alexi was hilarious. And he could draw all the tattoos on him and like walk around pretending to be drunk and talking about how he fought Captain America.
Oh my God, that was so funny. I was dying of laughter when that scene happened. Like when he was like in jail, just like breaking people's arms.
He was the unsung hero of the movie.
He was funny. He was great. He was annoying, but he was good. Like,
he was annoying at all. Anytime he came on the screen, my face lit up. I was like, yeah.
Oh no, I was excited to see him. I was just like, I can only imagine being in prison with him, like having to hear the story 1,000 times about how he fought Captain America.
Fucked up how they put him in prison, though.
Oh, yeah, I agree.
We said all we had to say. You know, any comments you guys have about the movie, I mean, we would love to hear it. You can go on our Instagram, randombitches_podcast.
Yes, let us know if you liked the movie, if you hated the movie, what you liked about it. Yeah. Tell us.
Let us know which Marvel character are you.
Oh, yes. Let us know what Marvel character
like, are
you
are.
Thor
that like
would
me?
Be fun.
Like, you know, muscles and a Viking and stuff? Are you like me? Are you like, you know, Black Widow know-it-all like Jessica? Or are you different?
I love how that's why you're just going to say it.
I was like, are you a Viking and beautiful man like me? A precious gem of a man, Thor?
Oh my God.
Are you like, you know, a know-it-all, like Jessica and Black Widow.
Like me.
But like, she is a know-it-all, but like she has the biggest heart and she gave herself up for the world. Like, are you that bitch? You know, so let us know who you are. Follow us. You can follow Jessica where?
Deep as the stars.
Follow me at King Liza on Instagram. KINGG_LAIZAA. Join our family, especially on the podcast Instagram, because we want to be interactive. Jessica posted a reel who got a lot of views. Congratulations, Jessica.
Oh, thank you. That was I was actually really amazed by
my
that.
Ass is like, peeing wow. myself. I was like, oh, I'm famous now.
I told everybody at work. I was like, oh my god guys, look at this is crazy. And then everyone was like, how many times did you watch that yourself, Jessica? And I was like, wow.
You know, so like, you know, give us 5 stars, leave a comment, love us.
Oh, that's good stuff. Us.
And goodbye for now.
Ta-ta.
Till next Thursday. We're going to call it Thursday.
Thursday.
Because, you know, I'm Thor. So just remember that. And if you got Thor on that quiz wrong, that's me. You're somebody else.
You're obviously somebody else.
Yeah. I mean, maybe you could be like Thor in a multiverse, but in the real world, me. And Chris Hemsworth. We're one. We're one the same. That's all I'm saying.
Oh my God.
Okay. Okay. Signing off. Bye.
Bye.